Hey, I'm Josh Thomas, and this is The Breakdown. Definitely in Please Like Me, I like didn't think about it, right? Like, I was really surprised when we made Please Like Me, and then everyone wanted to talk about how I was gay, because like, I'm gay, right? And like, I'm gay all the time. I wasn't thinking about like, it is like a social action initiative. I wasn't trying to help like gay teens, and I wasn't thinking about like, oh, how is this gonna fit into the queer media landscape? I just was like telling my story on screen, and like the character is based on me. Now that I've had like a million conversations about it, I think what people like is that it was very specific, and it wasn't, the character wasn't made from that point of view, which is like something that I did by accident. Now I've like realized that like representation and how things fit into the media landscape, and you know, I realize they're really important and I'm more like conscious of them, but I like learned the lessons from that show where I really didn't have a choice about what that character was. I learned from that just to treat like these kind of issues, these like hot button issues, like how they are in real life, and not try and make a statement.
I met out with a boy.
I know.
Male boy.
I know, yeah.
Okay.
I don't understand though. Why would you do it in the same day that we break up?
I didn't mean to, I promise.
You don't want stereotypes in any character. It doesn't really matter who they're having sex with. I don't want to write characters that I've seen before. I want to write like new characters, and I want to introduce people to people that they haven't met.
Are you sure you don't have feelings you want to share with me in some kind of talk?
Yeah.
It can be good to share your feelings.
Nope.
The truth about love stories is they're really hard in a TV show because like watching like a couple get together, great, magic. Watching a couple break up, really good. Watching them get back together, interesting. Watching them together is like, it's not good. It's like really, it's really hard to script. When you watch a romantic comedy, you know, often the bit where they're together is like a montage. There's a reason for that. It's because seeing two people just be happy and comfortable is like really like not dynamic television. So I sort of just on this show, I just wanted to try and keep them together as much as I could. I do like it when couples are together, but unless they're, like if they're married, you know, there's like a great tension with them being married because they're stuck. And that sort of works in those kind of sitcoms when a couple's married, but then a lot of it comes from like, oh, I've got to deal with you and I've got no choice. And there's like tension in that.
I've always thought monogamy was archaic, like unnecessary pressure on relationships.
You want to go and have sex with other boys?
Like a young, happy couple just together is not, I can't think of that many examples of it in a TV show, and it's because it's dull. But we're trying really hard to do it.
Did you go to park, okay?
Yes.
I think Mum tried to kill herself.
You think?
I mean, that was like, when we started out with that, that was probably something where I was like more conscious of like, how I wanted to portray it. Because my mom, you know, she tried to kill herself, and that's what the show's based on. And one of the things I thought when it happened was like, I've never seen this on TV. Like usually when you watch TV, you kind of get these practice runs at like big emotional events, but suicide is always so janky. Like all the suicide attempts on TV were like, you know, someone was like standing on the side of a building or about to jump off a bridge, and then the person would like talk them down, or it wasn't really very nuanced. And I'd never really seen anything that tried to explain why people try and kill themselves. It's something that people are really confused about. It's really hard to understand. And when someone close to you tries to kill themselves or does kill themselves, the reactions people have are like kind of nuts. So I was like, I was proactively trying to make a show where we showed someone and kind of showed their side of it and their like point of view. I thought that was like an important thing, an important story to tell, and that was like how I convinced my mum to let me.
Who's your next of kin?
You are.
I can't be your next of kin. Mm. You're my next of kin. Mm. I'm the child.
Hannah's character, played by Hannah Gadsby, was very much like, it was hers, so like I would do a lot of the story, but she would otherwise be in charge of that character. But also I really wanted, you know, she had like a really nice insight into mental illness that was like way better than mine. You know, it's just another thing that I feel like people don't talk about that much in like a serious way. Like I think anxiety disorders, you know, it's one of these things that people sort of claim to have when they don't have, and they kind of seem a bit sort of frivolous. when I got to know this friend and I understood what like his like really pretty serious anxiety disorder means and how that like affects his life, that was like interesting. So I stole it and put it on TV.
Some people think they have to be nice to me because I'm different, but actually they don't like me. Is that what you're doing?
I actually really gotta go to the bathroom.
I wanted to have an autistic character because I'm kind of like drawn to neurodiverse people. And it was another thing I felt like, I feel like I hadn't been done on TV very well. And especially with girls, so like no girl autistic characters, like literally zero, let alone a female autistic lead. All those lessons I learned about representation and Please Like Me that I learned by accident, just because like I was basing it on me and just be telling the truth and not trying to be clever. I like tried to like use them with Matilda, where like, even though she's a fictional character, I really wanted to like make sure we were just working on this specific person and understanding like how she grew up and her backgrounds and how that would make her as a person and how like autism factored into that, instead of trying to make some statement about what autism is, or trying to feel like we're like representing all autistic people, because that's impossible. Like autism is like a super broad group of people. So that's how we like tackled that character. I just would always be like, you know, we're not doing autism, we're doing Matilda.
Let's try it all again. We'll just do it again together.
I can't.
It's just gonna get better and better at
I'm never gonna be able to do this alone.
I really wanted like my autistic character be sex focused, you know? I wanted to like make autism sexy, just because it just, again, people are like shy about it, they're scared of it.
I asked him for sex. I wasn't specific about whether or not it had to be good.
Parents and carers of autistic people are really scared of their sexuality and how they're gonna handle it. I don't know, it's just like more fun, isn't it? Like sex is fun. I like sex focused storylines. I like sex positivity. I really like her like different point of view on it, especially the experiences she has in the show.
I don't like hugs. Dad taught me to do them when I was young and they made him happy, so I did it for him. But I was hoping since he's dead now, I wouldn't have to do them anymore.
When we started doing research, I found that like there's a huge like crossover between autism and queerness and transness, actually, which I think is really interesting, and I don't know what it is. Like, I've asked a lot of people, and a lot of people have like their opinions about why there's so many more autistic people that are queer. Some people say they think that it's just that autistic people are like much more practiced at learning to be true to themselves and not worry about what other people think, at being like in check with their own feelings and communicating their needs. So I don't know, when I found that out, I was like, of course they're gonna be queer. Like, if you give me permission to make more characters queer, then I'm gonna do it, of course.